Welcome, avid learner of linguistics. In this video, I want to introduce you to the wonderful world of corpora, which can serve as a really helpful tool when it comes to research in linguistics. I recall reading a text about grammatical change by Laurie Bauer, in which he describes how he tried to figure out how the rule of comparing adjectives changed over time. And what he did is, he read through lots and lots of newspapers to scan them for adjectives and comparative, to see whether two-syllable words had an ER added or if they were preceded by the word more. Well, poor guy. His job would have been so much easier had there been computers and digital texts around in the time those newspapers were printed. So what's the point of this, though? Well, what Bauer did was he basically treated those newspapers like a corpus. Alright, what is a corpus? If you know me, you know that I like to explain words by saying where they come from, so here you go. I'm so predictable. The word corpus comes from Latin and means body, and incidentally, it's the same root for the word corpse, for obvious reasons, I guess. So, a corpus is a body, we've established that. But what kind of body? Coming to think of it, using the word body is really just a metaphor. I think I'll just post a link to my metaphor video somewhere around here. Definition. A corpus is a collection of authentic texts commonly used for the purpose of research. Yes, it's that simple. By authentic, we mean that the texts were written by native speakers. And in a way, really everything can be a corpus. Newspapers, novels, recipes, Facebook posts, tweets, you name it. How does it all work then? Well, let's assume you're a massive Justin Bieber fan, dear viewer, which could be about accurate if I look at the demographics of my videos. So you're a Justin Bieber fan and you want to dedicate your time to analyzing his linguistic prowess. What you could do is you could gather every single tweet he has ever written and save them in one file. Now this is your corpus, a very simple one, but it's fully functional already. And with the right software, you can now look at things in your Belieber corpus, such as word frequency, collocation, or even concordance. But what are those three things? I'm so glad you asked. Let me show you that with an example. I have not compiled a Justin Bieber corpus though, because fuck it, time's too precious. I'll just take a simple text file of one of my literary studies assignments and run it through a free software called AntKong. Right, word frequency helps you check how often a word appears in a text. This can be really useful because that will allow you to make statements about the register and audience of the text. My most frequently used words here? The, of, to, and a. And then the words rivers and shell shock, which isn't much of a surprise because the essay actually was about shell shock and a shell shock therapist called Rivers. In collocation, you can look at kinds of words that seem to appear in close proximity. They sort of form pairs, and in an authentic text, this will tell you a lot about which words are more likely to combine in a language. In my example here, I screen my corpus for collocates of the word shell shock. Here, it tells us how often these collocations appear, and if the collocate is to the left or to the right of my search item. And finally, concordancing, which is probably the most pleasing to OCD people, because not only does it make pretty, pretty columns, it allows you to see what bigger chunks of language surround your search item in the corpus. Really cool. So as you see, corpus analysis has lots of benefits. First of all, it deals with relatively objective data and can be easily carried out with huge quantities of text. Also, it's a descriptive method, and that's always a plus, isn't it? Also, working with corpora can be really beneficial to high-proficiency language learners. Not sure about the preposition you have to use after abide? Just look it up in a corpus. And here's a pro tip for simple things like this. Even Google's frequency count can be really helpful as well. So, moving on, corpus linguistics grants insight into really interesting fields of linguistics, such as morphosyntactic patterns, processes of language change, or even lexical traces of discourses. And that's it. Now you've got a general idea of corpora. Did you like the video? Then please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Wow! So by analyzing a text with a concordance, I could actually find traces of discourses? That's really, really neat! But what's a discourse though? Oh, don't panic, avid viewer, I've got you covered with another video. Just click here.